This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft inquiry tools. This video will demonstrate the inquiry panel on the SD inquiry ribbon. The commands in this video are distance, command alias D. This command allows you to traverse around line work, display the survey information of the points selected, either lines or arcs, and it'll also give a running total. So here it says, specify a starting point. But there are some options down here. One of them is multiple, so if you want it to allow you to pick multiple segments. Another is, do you want to display a path? You'll see shortly that'll be a magenta path. And do you want it to be continuous, or when you hit enter, it just stops. So here I'll select a point at the end of this lot line. Select endpoint at this lot line, so you can see the purple path. You can see the distance and bearing of that segment. Here you have the distance and bearing of that segment, and then the running total. Again, since we're doing a straight line, you have a distance and bearing, and then a running total. Now, since we're going to start an arc, you can select A for arc. It asks you to select a point on the arc. So I just select the near, and then at the endpoint of the arc. Now it's showing you the delta, radius, length, tangent, chord, and bearing, and then the running total up to this point. Again, we want to do an arc, and then the endpoint. Since we've come back around to the starting point, now we have the perimeter information, delta, radius, length, tangent, chord, and bearing of that. If you just wanted to do a bunch of segments, you can see that it's giving you a running total and showing you at the crosshairs the last segment done, bearing and distance. The next command is the measure angle command. The command alias is AN. This command allows you to determine an angle between two line segments, be them in the drawing or in a block or X reference, polyline, it doesn't matter. The angle compared to a line and an arc or two arcs. And it also displays information about the endpoints. Do two endpoints match if the two lines touch each other? Or if a line intersects, it will say they don't match. If it actually touches on the line, it will say endpoints are on that line. So it's a very good tool, especially when doing like subdivision work. So I can select this line segment, and this will give you the angle and say the endpoint of the second line that I selected is on the first line, so there's no gap there. What's really interesting about this measure angle command, if you were to select two lines that are parallel, it's not going to come back with an error saying those don't intersect. It's going to say those are parallel and then give you the offset distance. If it was two arcs and they were concentric, it would say those arcs are concentric and then it would give you an offset distance. So if we were to zoom into this section where you actually have a straight section going in, a straight segment going into an arc, selecting the straight segment, selecting the arc, telling you that that straight segment is radial to that arc, or would give you a deflection angle if it wasn't radial. What's also nice is if you were to select lines that actually should match endpoints, this arc and this straight segment, for example, here it says the line is tangent to the arc, which is exactly what it should be, and the endpoints match. As I showed you earlier, when you select a lot line, and then here would be the property line, you can say that those lines are perpendicular in this particular case, and the endpoint of the first line is on the second line. If I was to select this lot line, which extends past the property line, you could actually see that it says endpoints do not match. So it's giving you some information, so quickly you can do some spot checking to see if these two have the same endpoints. Endpoints match, it tells you what the deflection angle. Here it says you actually have a deflection angle off of that line and arc, and that first line is on the arc, so there's no gap. So that's the measure angle command. ID point, or IDP, is the command alias, allows you to display the coordinates of a selected point at the command prompt. It gives you both the XY values of that coordinate and the northing and easting. The next command is the ID elevation, and it will display the elevation of a selected object at the crosshairs. Since this whole drawing is at zero, It's not going to be anything of interest, but you can actually see where it says elevation of these various objects is 0. Next is the length or add command, and it has the ability to do a couple different things. You can either select some line work, hit enter, and it will tell you how many segments they were and give you both their 2D and 3D links, or you can go into a dialog box interface using various filters, either all the layers or all the objects that are on the lot layer that have a particular line type. You can specify various filters if there's any polylines on that particular layer or if it's just going to be the lines and arcs. Tell it to process, and it actually adds up the 2D and 3D information of all the lines and arcs on whatever filter options you have selected in the dialog box. The next command is the list command. And unlike the AutoCAD list command, this one formats the information in survey units. So it'll give you a bearing and distance. It would give you deltas, radiuses, chords, tangents for arcs. And it shows you that information at the command line. It doesn't matter if it's within a polyline. It will just show you the segment that you selected, or does it matter if it's in a block or Xref, or if it's intelligent objects, the information about the segment, not the whole piece, but the segment that you select. So here I select a line, it gives me the bearing and distance. Here I select an arc, it gives me all the arc information. As you can tell by me hovering over this, this is a polyline, but I'm selecting an arc segment of that. It'll give me the arc information of that segment. I go to the very first piece, which is a straight line segment. It gives me the straight line segment. I'm going to switch drawings to a Civil 3D drawing. Here you can actually see that we have an alignment, which is a Civil 3D alignment. I will go again and use the list command. You can see that this is an alignment in Civil 3D, and I'm going to select it, and it'll give me information about that segment that I'm selecting. Next, I'm going to switch drawings again. This drawing has a lot of blocks in it. The last command on the inquiry panel is count blocks. Selecting the command, it says select objects. You can use a fence, you can use a window, or you can just type all, and it finds all the blocks in this drawing. You hit enter, it actually gives you a list of every block that's in the drawing and the count of those blocks. And what's interesting is if you have dynamic blocks that have different visibility states, it counts those blocks individually by whatever the current visibility state is. What's nice about this is you can save this out to a comma delimited file so you can bring it into a spreadsheet and start using it for quantity takeoffs. That concludes the demonstration of the inquiry panel on the SD inquiry ribbon. Thank you.